If you are thinking of pursuing law in 2021, then definitely many questions must be coming in your mind. And these questions must be coming in the mind of those who have scored very good ranks in CLAT and those also whose scores are not so good. So hello everybody, welcome back to Kingdom of Learning. So in this video we are going to discuss about some very important issues. So watch the video till last, and if you have not subscribed to the channel yet, do it fast. So let's start now. So actually, what are we going to cover up in this video? First of all, we will discuss about the NLUs, means the National Law Universities, means what are they and why students dream for them. Then we will see what are their benefits. Then we will compare them with private law colleges. So I think this video is going to be very useful for all of you. So now, first of all, let us see that these NLUs, National Law Universities, are the dream target of every student who wants to go for law. But there are certain students who don't prefer these NLUs, and there may be certain reasons for that. So whether they should go for private law colleges or not, that we are going to discuss. So now let us see that these tier 1 law universities according to the NIRF ranking 2020. So these are, first of all, there is National Law School of India University, Bangalore, then NALSAR, Hyderabad, then there is HNLU, Raipur, Chhattisgarh, then GNLU, Gandhinagar, then NLIU, Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh. I'll place the list here, you can check it out. So these are the most famous or most desired NLUs. So then we have National Law University of Delhi, National Law University of Jodhpur, and this National University of Kolkata, West Bengal. So these are the tier 1 NLUs. If you have got very good scores, you should definitely go for these universities. And actually, these are all situated in the main or big cities of India. That's why they are known as tier 1. And all the other National Law Universities which are situated in other cities, they are known as tier 2 national universities. So now what are the advantages of going to these national law universities? The first and the most important thing is that these are top rated law institutes in India. Most importantly, these are opted by CLAT toppers. So definitely you are going to get a very good atmosphere here. And apart from that, these are government institutes. So many benefits are there. Means they have good infrastructure and every facility is provided to the students by the government. So now we have to see why private colleges. Means for some reason, if you are not able to make up for these national law universities, then whether you should go for private colleges or not. So here I want to make one thing very much clear, that there are so many private law institutes also which have been provided almost equal status as government law universities. So actually Symbiosis has been given a rank by NIRF also. Definitely these institutions have best infrastructure, their faculty, their placements, their, you can say, exposure of the students, everything is at par, or sometimes it is even better than NLUs. So here we can say that in these colleges students are provided lot of exposure, because what is the difference? Like in NLUs only law courses are there, but in private colleges you can interact with students of other courses also. Means there are so many courses going on simultaneously in the same college, and you can get an exposure of getting knowledge about those courses also. You can make friends of those courses also. And even some private colleges have very good faculties, and even international faculties are hired by them. Moreover, there are like certain private law colleges which have made student friendly environment, and they have created their curriculum in a very interesting and innovative manner. So all these things can attract some students to go for private colleges instead of NLUs. So now we will see some disadvantages of these private colleges. One is definitely the fee is very high. Sometimes it will go above 7 lakhs per year. Then the curriculum of some colleges is very vast and it may be difficult for average students to continue with that curriculum. Means sometimes what happens that those students whose scores are not so good and those whose rank is not so good in CLAT, they go for private colleges. But here when they go there, they find that the curriculum or the syllabus is so vast, it is so complicated that they have to leave it in between. So if you are thinking of pursuing law colleges, you must be mentally prepared that you definitely you will have to study a lot. Because law courses, their curriculum is definitely very vast. So if you are mentally prepared for that, then you should go ahead. So then there are certain colleges where means otherwise internships are provided by these private colleges. But in some colleges, students are not provided with internship facilities and rather they themselves have to find these placements and they have to move here and there. So now we will see which are these best law colleges in India which are non-NLUs. Means although they have great placement assistance, great infrastructure, they have modern teaching methods and their method of teaching is also very great. So we are going to see which are these colleges. So here first of all this is ALSA Hyderabad Telangana. You can see the list. I will provide the list here. So first is this college. Then we will see which are the other colleges which are private but still they are providing very good facilities and you can opt for them. But you have to see which colleges are suitable to you according to your location. Then we have MIT University, Mumbai. Then we have Tirthankar Mahavir University, Uttar Pradesh, Sage University, Indore. Then ICFAI University, Jaipur, Rajasthan. Then we have Chandigarh University, Punjab, Lovely Professional University, Jalandhar, Punjab. Then OP Jindal Global University, Sonipat, Haryana. Then ILS Law College, that is in Pune, Maharashtra. So these are some other options where you can go for law courses. So no need to worry much. There are so many options for everybody. You can choose these colleges according to your budget and your other facilities. Then we have this SLC College, Pune, Maharashtra. Then we have ILNU, Ahmedabad, Gujarat. So these are some of the top private universities where you can go without thinking much. So one more advice I want to give to all law aspirants that if you are thinking of pursuing any course in law, definitely you will have to work very hard because the curriculum is very vast. So no university or no college will be useful if you do not want to do hard work. So best of luck all of you. I think I have provided you enough information. Still if you have any doubt, you can ask in the comment box. And if you have not subscribed to the channel yet, do it fast. Because we are providing you complete support and guidance and we are bringing videos on daily basis. Thank you.